Just a few months ago, Scott Walker was a front runner in the Republican race for president, but now he's out. And some say his departure could shake up the playing field for the GOP.
On the Democratic side, Hillary Clinton's campaign could be facing yet another challenge if Vice President Joe Biden decides to throw his hat in the ring. Heather Sells has the story.
In the end, I believe that the voters want to be for something and not against someone.
Just this summer, Wisconsin Governor Scott Walker led the Republican field in Iowa. On Monday, he called it quits and suggested that someone could emerge from a smaller pool of candidates with a clear conservative alternative to the current frontrunner, Donald Trump.
I believe that I'm being called to lead by helping to clear the field in this race so that a positive conservative message can rise to the top of the field.
But will others drop out so that support can build around a challenger to Trump? None are expected to do so anytime soon. In fact, they're all scrambling right now around the Walker campaign assets.
Some believe that Senator Marco Rubio will benefit the most from Walker's departure. They're both considered fresh faces with next-generation appeal. Late Monday, Rubio was already welcoming Walker's staff to his team, as was Senator Ted Cruz. The latest CNN poll shows political outsiders Trump, Carly Fiorina, and Ben Carson leading the presidential pack, with Rubio and Jeb Bush in fourth and fifth place. On the Democratic side, Hillary Clinton is battling off an unexpectedly strong challenge from socialist Bernie Sanders and waiting to see if Vice President Joe Biden decides to enter the race.
If you just look at the facts, things work better when there's a Democrat in the White House.
Her latest campaign move, promising not only to protect Obamacare from GOP plans to repeal it, but to improve it. It's already a presidential campaign year that no one could have predicted, and voters have never had so many candidates to consider. But whether any of them will follow Walker's advice and lead by falling back is unlikely for now. Heather Sells, CBN News.
In other news, security is extremely tight as Pope Francis arrives in the United States today. Ephraim Graham has that story from the CBN newsroom. Ephraim?
Gordon, some experts are calling it the biggest security operation in the history of the country. The Pope will be in the U.S. for 6 days, visiting three major cities. He'll start in Washington, where he'll visit the president and speak to Congress. Then he'll go to New York on Thursday, where he'll celebrate Mass in Madison Square Garden. And Saturday, he'll hold a prayer gathering with the World Meeting of Families and celebrate another Mass with a crowd expected at more than 1 million people. The Senate votes today on a bill banning abortions after 20 weeks. It is called the Pain-Capable Unborn Child Protection Act because supporters of the measure say unborn babies can feel pain at that point and could survive outside the womb.
Scientific evidence on this point is incontrovertible. 5 months into pregnancy, unborn babies feel pain.
The House already passed the 20-week abortion ban, but even if the Senate also passes it, President Obama is expected to swiftly veto it. A survey of defectors from ISIS found many quit the organization because they decided it was too brutal or corrupt, or because it too often went to war against other Sunni Muslims. The survey was issued on Monday by a think tank based in London. It is based on public statements of 58 people who have left ISIS since last year. The author of the report said the findings shatter the image of unity and determination that ISIS tries to show. And he says if enough people hear about them, the defector's statements could prevent future recruits from joining ISIS. And let's go back to Gordon.
Well, that would be a good thing if we can possibly stop that kind of recruiting. But I think more importantly, we need to show Muslims everywhere that there's a better way. And now more than ever, we need to preach the gospel to the Muslim world.